Welcome, my name is Dennis Nikles. I'm running IoT business for Deutsche Telekom, and welcome to the third episode of Dennis Meets. I am really excited to be here in Palo Alto with Skylo and with Parthsarathi Trivedi, who is the founder and the CEO of Skylo.
Dennis, it's a real pleasure to have you in Skylo and Palo Alto. Thank you so much for coming.
Skylo was founded in 2017, a very young company, but in this short period, you have a really proven track record. Yeah, you have partners like SoftBank, and you were able really to bring satellite connectivity on 5G devices without changing anything. Could you explain a little bit to our audience what Skylo actually is doing and delivering to your customers?
Sure thing, Dennis. Skylo provides a service that allows your cellular IoT devices and wearables to connect directly over satellite when a cell signal isn't available. And this service will allow you to basically send text messages, send an SOS, or share your location where you couldn't in the past. I mean, think about all the times that you're driving through areas that don't have cell reception, and you need to track something important, or you just need to reach out for help. There's really no efficient way to do that today without a cell coverage. By connecting these devices directly over satellite, you know, the way we do that is we work directly with chipset companies, the device makers, and of course our cellular mobile operator partners to create a seamless extension of their existing coverage footprint and allow devices to connect and roam onto our satellite network without any change to their existing antenna or hardware. Mm. In effect, devices that use our service never lose coverage.
You mentioned already some of the most important IoT use cases here. And for us, providing IoT services to our customers, right, global coverage is really a must.
Yes.
Yeah, and therefore, we are looking as well in working together with you, yeah, in overcome the normal barriers of terrestrial networks you have, yeah, in having white spots and really to providing a full-blown global coverage, yeah, which is a basis for any IoT use case and so on. And we see as well a lot of industry asking for that. Yeah, we both joined 5G AA automotive event, yeah, where our automotives asked already for that. Yeah, therefore, as we are really strong in our terrestrial network, being the only transatlantic carrier, yeah, we are looking forward, yeah, to expand our coverage together with you. Yeah, that's really interesting.
I think that's a really good way to put it, Dennis. If I could summarize customer needs in one word, it would probably be predictability. Mm-hmm. Whether that's predictable cost, predictable coverage, or predictable quality of service. Mm-hmm. And I truly believe that with TIoT's cellular foundation across two continents, provides us the perfect opportunity to springboard off of both existing use cases as well as dive into completely unexplored territory into use cases that could never be served before.
Let's dig a little bit deeper into that. How can our joint customers can consume the service?
So there's a couple of ways that devices and customers using those devices can access this service. We run a narrowband IoT or NB-IoT network over satellite, which means that any device that is running the NB-IoT protocol today can connect to our network, provided we have certified it. We are working with devices that are either standalone NB-IoT or that are dual mode that run Cat-M1 and NB-IoT on it, which typically all IoT devices and wearables, majority of those devices fall into one of those two categories today. So we certify those devices working very closely with the chipset maker and the device maker onto our network. And to the end customer, actually the service is quite transparent. The end customer doesn't need to think about how the device switches between cellular and satellite, which I think is the key. You know, you really shouldn't have to think, well, will I have coverage there or not? Will I have to take any steps or not to access that coverage? And so we've, at the firmware level, made it really easy for these devices to seamlessly switch between the cellular terrestrial network of TIoT and the Skylo satellite network.
Yeah, I think the seamless, yeah, the word seamless is really important here for our customers. Yeah, without additional infrastructure, antennas or something like that, keeping the costs low and keeping the integration efforts for our customers as well low. Yeah, therefore, the seamless part of this story is really important. Yeah, therefore, from my perspective, what we see here in our partnership with Skylo is how we can really close white spots we have in our terrestrial networks with the satellite connectivity provided by Skylo without any additional efforts on customer side, seamlessly integrated into the existing environment, into existing 3GPP standards and so on, which is really outstanding. Yeah, but Parth, coming now to this nice devices here on the table. If you think about application, what is the application you are most excited about?
Well, personally, I just came back from a camping trip, and I'm really excited about the use case of wearables. Our team was successful in connecting a smartwatch, mm-hmm. a rugged smartwatch, directly over satellite, which is something I probably would have taken with me on that trip. But if you think about essential personnel that need to be monitored or kept safe in the field, that's a perfect use case for them. Whether they're first responders, whether they're members of the agricultural community, or whether they're essential workforce in mining. Mm-hmm. Here, for instance, we have a device from Flextronics, which is the I-enable IoT platform, which could be used, for instance, in the asset tracking context, whether you're tracking pallets, containers, or vehicles in the automotive sector. You know, we're finding that customers today want visibility across the supply chain. If you can, you know, sort of understand what's going on in recent events, mm-hmm. Visibility now to them is more important than ever before. And constant coverage is something that I've heard over and over again from our customers across sectors.
Yeah, what we can see here on such devices is really the benefits of your technology, right? If we think about satellite, yeah, we are all thinking about big That's antennas right. and so on, yeah. But this small device can speak a mobile network, yeah, narrowband IoT, Cat-M, you mentioned already. And satellite, and this is really amazing.
That's right. I think that's the key, Dennis, that satellite connectivity is no longer restricted to a proprietary form factor.
Yeah.
It is now available to developers across a range of different form factors mm-hmm. and all wrapped up in a single solution that's provided through, for instance, TIoT and all under a single bill. With developer-friendly APIs.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. By the way, Parth, we should tell our audience that we will launch this service as part of our TIoT offering in Europe in 2023. Looking really forward to that date. Thank you for having me here in Palo Alto in your offices. Really nice location you have here. Yeah, and I'm really looking forward to our cooperation to bring the connectivity to the next level.
Thank you, Dennis. It was a real pleasure to host you at Skylo.
Thank you.